Hi viewers, good evening. Today I came with a new concept which is how to enable the retroactive price update in R12. See, if you want to access my videos, you can go to YouTube, www.youtube.com/c/meetbusinessanalyst. So if you navigate here, you will find my videos, so you can access. And if you want to get this updates in your mail, please subscribe my channel. Well, we'll see how to enable the retroactive pricing and how it will work. Please navigate to the application. First setup you need to remember is you need to enable a profile option, so which is PO enable retroactive update of retroactive pricing of POs. So go ahead, profile, system, go to profile, put PO retro, so click on find. So you will find, see the PO allow retroactive pricing. I already enabled at site level as all releases. If you want to enable only for open release, that means new releases, if you want to access, you can go ahead. And if you want to use for never, so you can check it. For our case, we need to enable retroactive pricing for all releases. Let's take an example or real-time scenario where your buyer has been created a blanket purchase agreement with a wrong price, and we have successfully received the material and we made the invoice as well. Now the buyer realized that he has issued the BPA with the wrong price and he made the releases as well. So then you don't want to cancel the previous release, you don't want to cancel the earlier invoices. So without doing that, you want to update the price in earlier release as well as in earlier invoice. So in that scenario, this will work. This will help them to update the correct price in the previous releases and previous invoices as well. Alright, now after this, the second setup is you need to give the retroactive account adjustment. Since there is a change in the price, hence you should record somewhere. So that will be available in our receiving parameters. You can go to your setup, organization, parameters, receiving options. So here you need to give a retroactive price adjustment account. So that will help even when there is a change in the price, so that will go and hit into this particular account. It will open web page. So in 11 it was opening the Java forms, now in R12 it is opening the web page. It is taking some time. Select your inventory organization here, click on go. So you will find list of values here. Go to here in the receiving option. See here, retroactive price adjustment account. You need to keep some account, so that is related to the retroactive which I have selected here. If you want, you can click it. You will find what account I have selected. So you have to put the correct account in your value sets. So here, adjustment account I have selected. Alright, go ahead and hit save. So I would like to create accounts automatic creation of invoices. So I believe which I have covered in my earlier videos. So if you want to know that, please go ahead and check it out. Yeah, we can go ahead and check the changes has been saved successfully. So which supplier and which site, you know, I have enabled self billing at receipt, so I need to check that. So I'm going to supplier setup, so that I will keep that site. So that's the way I want to create invoices automatically. I don't want to make it manually. All right here you can click on update, so it will take you to the supplier details. Now go to purchasing. Under purchasing, go to self billing. In self billing, I have selected Sleepwell Chennai location, pay and receive. So I am going to use this location. Alright. Now go ahead and create blanket purchase agreement for any one of the item. Purchasing, purchase orders, purchase order. Okay, so now the order has been opened. Go ahead and select blanket purchase agreement. So supplier is Sleepwell, location is Chennai location. So, and this is for PO Retroactive price update demo. Come here. So whenever you put blanket purchase agreement, remember three things: the quantity is not available and there should be no schedule dates, no shipment dates. Put your item. So it will bring all the details here. Will bring the item category, description, unit of measure. If this item has any list price at item level, it will bring that list price here. So whatever you want to change, you can go ahead and change it. See here, 150 is the item quantity. So anything else we need to put? So since it is a blanket purchase agreement, agreement should have some dates, effective dates. So keep that in mind, put some effective date. I am giving some effective days between this date to this date. There should be no changes in my price, and I would like to put amount here so that it will default over there. Some this much amount, it will get update to my term. Yeah, you can see minimum releases, how much you want to minimum release. At least let's suppose I would like to release at least 1000 rupees. Anything else? Yeah, fine. Go ahead and hit save. System will generate the PO number based on the financial option setup where we have purchasing option setup where we have kept the what is the purchase order number sequence. So we can see that here that will default. So you can check it out, the order number has been generated. 4059 is our order number. So I am noting down in some notepad. So which is best practice, you may forgot. Go ahead and approve it. Go ahead, hit OK. May take some time, so I'm pausing video. See, now the blanket purchase agreement has been successfully approved. So now we will make a release. So with the price 150, keep that in mind. So with price 150 we are going to make the release. So how to make the release? You can go either release screen or you can make through purchase order summary screen. I'm going to purchase order summary screen. From here I would like to make the release. Just click on, put your blanket purchase number here, click on new releases or alt B. So that form will open. It will bring all these details. You no need to supply any details in your release screen. So that is why I am going through this screen. Now you can see the information has been bring from purchase order number. So come here and click details, like what information you want it. Anyhow, there is only one line and we have one shipment, so it is no issue to search. You can put one everything one, so system will bring that. The important thing is you need to remember which organization you are giving. So our organization is here PN1. Come on, PN1. Yes, UPN system will bring the organization name, right? It's a short code. So how much quantity you are expecting? Let's suppose I am expecting some odd quantity 17, and when your supplier has been promised, he has been promised on 4th, and when the need by date is, see, we are in October. I believe I didn't open my purchasing periods and I didn't open my GL periods, so I didn't open my inventory period, it seems. So I will open all them. All right, see, go ahead and hit save, and I will open my payable periods. Otherwise system will throw couple of error messages. It won't create automatic invoices, etc. To avoid that, I will open all the periods. Let me pause for a sec. So it has been successfully created, release 1. Go ahead and approve it. It has been bringing the distribution details from item information something, and go to receiving control. I would like to make it direct. I don't want to go through this type of routing, I mean standard routing. So I'm going to make it approved. So I put direct delivery as receipt routing. So as and when I make the save and receipt screen, so it will bring on hand quantity update, as well as it will push the records into open interface. Go ahead and OK it. So you will find the release has been approved successfully. It seems I have opened October period as well, purchasing periods. Otherwise we may encounter issue. So go ahead and check. It has been approved successfully. Now we will make the receipt. So go ahead and make the receipt. Purchasing, receiving, receipts. So which is our organization? This is our organization. So before going that, I would like to release, I mean open the periods. In inventory, accounting close period, inventory accounting period. So PN1 is my organization. So I would like to open October period, so which is future period. I am changing the status. Okay, we will run a control program and the status will go and make it open. Right, has been open. Now similarly we will open purchasing period as well. So setup, financial, accounting, control purchasing period, and as well as open close periods. It will be your GL periods. After that we will open AP period as well. So which period we are looking for? October 16. You can open. So find. It is taking some time. Fine. Alright, see, it is future period. I am open period. Okay, target is October 16. Yes, I would like to open. Yes. Now control purchasing period, which one I am opening? October 16. Go ahead. Anyhow, it is there. It is never opened. Go ahead and hit open. So, save it. Yeah, if you click on go, you will find it has been opened. Now similarly, so it has been opened this period as well. So you come back and query it. We will see it is still in future status since the program is not completed. So we will check the status of the period, I mean program. The program should be completed normal, so that October period will open. Let the program will open. Similarly we will open payable periods. Payable, setup, where are you? Calendar, no. Accounting, accounting period. Yes, this is the navigation. So which one would you like to open? October. So I have already opened the payable period for this month. Okay, so fine. So now I am making the PO receipt. Going to purchasing, receiving, receipts. For the first time it will ask the inventory organization. So we already selected that. Go ahead and put your purchase order number. So it is the first release, right? So you can, if you want, you can put the release as well. Find. go ahead and select this. If any of your periods GL or purchasing periods are not open, you will experience couple of issues here, errors. So put the sub inventory. I have two sub inventories. I will select the correct sub inventory so that the quantity will hit into correct sub inventory, right? Go ahead and save it. So RCU processing mode is immediate, so it will run the receiving transaction processor immediately. If we put batch mode, we need to manually run it. If it is online, we can't check it. System will run that background. So this is our receipt number. Keep a habit of taking this in a notepad so that you don't miss anything. Go ahead and check it out. So view request. Fine. There will be three programs which will run. Once the receiving transaction processor get completed, then it will call two more programs. Okay, based on the setup which we did. We would like to create invoice also automatically. So for that, you need to keep the profile option POERS invoice number prefix. Then you need to set at supplier level as self-billing pay on receipt. You need to select and invoice summary. You have to select as receipt. So once you have set up that, system will do this process. Since we are creating direct delivery, once we have successfully received, system will call that program as well. Let this get complete, we will see that. See, we can check the type is immediate mode here. This is coming based on RCV processing mode. Alright, see, yes, it is taking time still. I don't know why today it is taking time. See now, yes, it has been called the Payable Open Interface Program, and the ADS, Applied Digital Solutions. So this has been pushed the records into Open Interface, Pay on Receipt Auto Invoice, and you can see the Payable Open Interface also running automatically. So this will be your invoice ID, okay? So you will see the invoice number with the ERS dash today state with some reference number. So we will check that as well. Once this is get completed, alright, we can check it. Yeah, it has been completed successfully. If you go ahead and check your invoice number with your purchase order number, you will find that payable invoices entry invoices. Your invoice number is purchase number is 4059. And check, yes, the form is open. Go ahead and find with your PO number. This is my PO number. Click on find. You can see there is one invoice number with the quantity, how much we have received. Some 17 we have received with 150 rupees. So that will be somewhere some 2000 something. That amount will come here. So much time. So now you can see the invoice number has been created with ERS, some 2550. Now the buyer has realized that he has wrongly given the quantity, wrongly mentioned the price, some 150 rupees. It should be less than 150 rupees. Let's suppose it should be some 130 rupees. Instead of 130, he has put 150, so it comes with the 150 rupees. So now he realized, and he don't want to affect the existing releases and existing invoices. That should reflect the new, you know, price. Then open the existing releases should be reflect the new price. So for this, what he will do is he can go to purchasing, he can go to the purchase order, he can go to the purchase orders. So we know our purchase order number is 4059. Query with 4059 here. 4059. Control F11. So now he is changing the price. So I'm putting 130 rupees. Yeah, it will go for request reapproval when I go ahead and save it. You can see the status is required reapprovals. Now you can see the release amount as well. It is 2550. Keep that note aside. 2550 rupees. Yeah, you are creating new revision and you can see the status as request we have to go to approve. Here the important thing you need to remember, what is that? Go to additional option, go to retroactive pricing. You need to check this, apply price update to existing POs and releases, and you need to communicate this price update to with your supplier and other parties. So go ahead and click on OK. This will go and approve it. The purchase order will go and approve since I have enough limits. After this, there is a program which you need to run it. There are lot of features, lot of checkboxes are available. So we never try that. So just try all this, so you will understand the beauty of Oracle EBS. But it has been approved successfully. Immediately what you need to do is, you need to run a program. Go to view, request, submit new request, okay. The program name is retroactive price update of purchasing. So put only retroactive, you will get a report name or a request name. So today my application is bit slow, so that's why I am pausing the video and coming back. Retroactive. Yeah, you can see retroactive price update of purchasing documents program. Hit that. So it will ask couple of parameters, so you need to provide that. Who is supplier? Sleepwell. Yes, site Chennai location. Agreement number 4059. So I don't want to mention any item, so I can directly go ahead and communicate updates. I'll say yes, I'd like to make a communicate updates to my supplier. Go ahead and submit. No. Okay. This is another setup you need to remember. Yeah, it has been completed. The next step is you need to run the workflow background process. Workflow background process for the item type. What is the type? You remember some tolerance. Okay. So PO change request tolerance check. This is the item type you need to select. And process default, you say yes, and I don't want to make any timeout. No, go ahead and submit. No, so this program should get complete. Yeah, it has been completed. Now go ahead and check your release. Purchasing, purchase order summary, and put your 4059 here, and select view releases checkbox here. Go ahead and find it. So you will find two. One is purchase order number, second is release. It is not updated as expected. So we will try one more time with I'm checking couple of information. I would like to go by some 132 rupees, and I'm saving this. Creating new document revision, yes. Approval. Going to additional options, retroactive price updates. I'm not checking the communicate price updates. It has been run. See, communicate price updates, it's checking for some of the reports or some of the programs, since you need to get update, right? Which is not happening. That is one of the reason. Okay, now I'm running the program. Admit new request, okay. What is that? Retroactive. Okay, updated. Price update of purchasing. Supplier Sleepwell. Okay, location Chennai. Agreement number. I don't want to send any price updates since there should be some setup required, it seems. Okay, or else I will leave it blank also. Let it be no. So let it get complete. Yes, it has been completed. I will run the workflow background engine. Go ahead and workflow background engine. Select the item type as PO change tolerance check. Tolerance. EBOs change, request tolerance, check. Yes, no. Submit. No. So go ahead and check the request. It has been completed. Now cross check the releases. Go to purchasing, purchase order, purchase order summary, put your EBO number here, click on releases, go ahead and find it. Yes, this time. No, this time also not reflected. Oops, let me click on open. What mistake we have made it? Any mistake we have made it? Nothing else? Something, any setup we are missing? So no price breaks, etc. We need to check. It won't work for cumulative pricing. Remember that. It won't work for cumulative pricing. That probably we missed out. So go ahead and change this. It is not creating anything, so I'll put some 135 rupees. I have create new region, approving, add operation option, retroactive filing. Okay, it will get approved. I was trying to make this video simpler, but it is going big video.
Okay.
So it won't work for cumulative pricing. Keep that in mind. I'm leaving everything blank. Go ahead and okay. Submit. No. Fine. We'll see. And this time the retroactive price update taking some time. That means something is happening. Yeah, it is running now. It is taking some time, so that something is happening in background. So we are, see, if it has been completed and it has been sent that EBO output for communication automatically ran. This means there is a update. So now go ahead and run workflow background engine. Anyhow, it automatically call. In case if you don't call, it is better to run that. Okay, tolerance. EBO check, check first tolerance check. Yes, no, okay, submit, no. Go ahead and check now, the request will get complete. Okay. It has been completed. Now go ahead and check your release now. Go ahead and purchasing, purchase order summary, put your PO number and view releases, go ahead and find it. Now if you check, the releases will get updated. See, earlier it was 2550, this time it has been changed to 22950. It will reflect to your invoice as well, but for that you need to run the price. If you check here, it was 150 earlier, now it is 135. So if you go ahead and check in your inventory, it will be reflect with this rate. The remaining gap of 15 rupees with 17 into 17, that will go into a retroactive price account, which we have kept at receiving parameters level. So for running invoice programs, I am not sure which program we need to run. So we'll quickly check any, what is that, pay on receipt, some program is there, pay receipt, fine. So pay on receipt auto invoice program is there. I will run this program, we'll see. What is the transaction source? I'm not sure what are the transaction source. Leave it okay. I'm running just blank. Let system fetch some records. If something is there, this pay on receipt program should call payable auto invoice program. We'll see. If it is not called, then the invoice price is not get updated as we expected. It will be remain 150 rupees. Okay. Let it get complete. Release is not updated with our price, even though I run that. Whereas for releases, it has been created. For invoices, I don't know which program need to run. That I will check and I will post into my different video. So thank you for watching. Please subscribe to the channel and share with your friends.